Let's head it down to Brendan Parker and Ryan Dittrick with tonight's Flames TV post-game show presented by Original 16.
Original 16, a great way to celebrate things done well.
Welcome inside our Flames postgame live. It is brought to you by Original 16, celebrating things done well. Brendan Parker alongside Ryan Dittrick here tonight, back on the desk and back on home ice for the Calgary Flames, kicking off a two-game homestand here tonight against the Los Angeles Kings, and a lot on the line, as we know, for the Los Angeles Kings, potentially sitting there right there in that playoff mix, but they suffer the loss here tonight and full marks to a Calgary Flames team who has talked a little bit most recently about feeling pretty good about some of the efforts they've put in and not so good about some of the results they've received. Tonight, the exact opposite. The work was there from the start, and they get the win. What did you see tonight?
Well, exactly what you said, full marks to the Calgary Flames, because this was a complete effort from stem to stern for them tonight. And, you know, all the talk, you know, as the Los Angeles Kings are going through Alberta, first stopping in Edmonton, is about how little this Kings team gives up. Well, flip the script a little bit, because through two periods, this Kings team is only able to manufacture about 9 shots on net. I think it was 10 after two. They took one away later. 5 shots at the midway point of the game total. So for a Flames team that was looking to get back on track, that's a pretty impressive defensive performance, but it really started with what they were able to do offensively. They tilted the ice early and often, yeah. And you know what, when it comes down to difference making, Ryan Huska has talked about it all year. Special teams have to be there for you. 3-for-6 on the power play for the Flames here tonight, and you know what, worthy of a little bit of a celebration. Mark Savard was the first guy off as the team came off the ice there, and he was showing a little bit of excitement, and rightfully so. They've worked hard on it all year. It's been a bit of a sore spot for them, but to see them get rewarded, especially after putting in some work on it this morning, it's good to see for this team as they look for some positives.
A couple of those, by the way, pretty efficient, and we'll hear from a couple of members of the Calgary Flames here momentarily, including a couple of 3 stars on this night. Nazem Kadri right at the top of that list. But first, maybe let's take a look at how it all went down here tonight and show you the highlights from tonight's hockey game. And we talk about how power plays, special teams played a huge role in this hockey game, and it didn't take long to showcase that less than 5 minutes in. And the early part of this power play, in fact, not too long after the faceoff win, it's Nazem Kadri that gets the lid lifter in this hockey game.
The seldom used bumper play for the Flames this season, but you see the head fakes there in slow motion from Andrei Kuzmenko. He's coming off a great game in St. Louis the other night too, so you know he's feeling it offensively, but that's good to see. You know, drive the defenders in, make a clean pass, quick touches. That's the key to a good power play.
So off and running are the Flames, but how about this power play answer from Adrian Kempke, and what a blast from him, as this thing was an absolute no-doubter.
This is a guy that scored 41 goals last year, so he knows how to find the net, but this shot is something special. I mean, that's in and out so quickly. How difficult, too. I mean, we'd have to ask him if he's intentionally looking for the far side there, but not much Jacob Markstrom could do in a situation like that.
We'll quickly show you one more here before we welcome in our first guest here tonight. But this is the goal that he ends up scoring. It's almost perfect timing. Martin Pospisil scores on the back door, and a nice setup there from Andrei Kuzmenko, who had a pair of assists in that first period. And maybe before we get to the rest of the highlights, we'll welcome in Martin now. And nice to see the goal there. And I know that started, that goal in particular started on the forecheck too. I think you were kind of the first one in there to create a little bit of havoc. Bodes well for what we saw tonight. Maybe just take me through that goal first and how you saw it develop and how you got in there.
Yeah, I think it was a good turnover, and I think Keds, he did a great job, a great play to Kuzi, and Kuzi made even nicer play to backdoor, so it was pretty easy to score, and it's fun to play with Keds and Kuzi, and I'm happy that I could help the team this way. So
yeah.
It's kind of a great look there in slow-mo, because that started at the blue line there for you. I'm curious, once you chip that along the wall, where's your mind at? Are you thinking go straight to the net at this point?
Go straight to the net. It's always in my mind. That's the first what comes to my mind, to go to the net. And, I play with the great players. They can make a play, so it was a nice pass by Kuzi.
You touched on Nas there in your first answer to Brendan. That first period especially, he was going. And I know we've talked a lot this year about what he's meant to you in terms of the leadership, but, you know, when a guy comes out and has a period like that, sets the tone for you guys, does that, you know, allow it easier for yourself to sort of get going as well and say, let's follow this guy?
Well, yeah, for sure. I think we both feeding from each other the energy, and I think it's fun to play with Cats. I mean, he's a great player, always ready to play, and it's something what I'm still learning, you know, to play every night the same way, you know, stay consistency, be hard to play against, and I think he's a pretty good example of that.
What impressed you the most about the team play here tonight? 5-on-5. I know there was a ton of power play goals in this game. I think 5 by the end of it, but 5-on-5. It really didn't seem like you guys gave up much. What stood out about the whole game that way?
Yeah, I think it was a good first period, and each line was I think was humming tonight, and that's what we need. You know, it was a great team effort, we just have to keep playing like that, and we can't get frustrated. You know, we are happy that we won tonight, and we still have lots of game left, so we just have to go day by day and win every try to win every game.
You said it there. So obviously the team's focus hasn't changed. You're 9 games left in the season. You want to get the wins. I'm curious for you personally, because it's been your first year in the NHL. You've taken great strides. I'm not suggesting the playoff race is over, but for you personally, what are some of your goals here as you go down the stretch and try to round out your game even more?
Yeah, I mean, maybe it sounds crazy, but for me, it's every game like a playoff game. So, I don't really looking what is going on around me. I just want to give it 100% out there, and what will happen. But, I just want to be always ready to play and help the team to win.
Good stuff, man. Appreciate the time. You took that stick up high, too. You're all good after that. I think you scored maybe the next shift later or a couple shifts later after that high stick.
Yeah, I think that this kind of stuff gets me going. So
yeah, there we go.
So, yeah, I'm glad that my thief is okay. So, I'm good.
Chicklets in place. Really.
I do that with Brendan every now and then. I got to get him going here before
it's
a guy.
Yeah, sometimes it's good.
Microphone to the face. Yeah. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it. Congrats on the win tonight.
Appreciate it, man.
There's Martin Pospisil had the goal in the early part of this hockey game, and a big one as it got the Flames off and rolling here tonight. That, by the way, was the 2-1 goal. I will resume the highlights at that point, because that was through one period of play and a nice part to leave, because as Martin steps in, Flames took that 2-1 lead into the second period, and they would get some more help. Saw this actually a couple of times tonight. The block shot originally, Lizotte takes that first one from Rasmus Anderson, but the second one directionally thrown at the net, and it directionally goes to Blake Coleman afterward.
Directionally, yes, indeed. Now, you know what? This is good, because we saw the success of the power play in that first period, the bumper spot, as we talked about, but it doesn't always have to be fancy, too. And you like how Rasmus Anderson kind of skates in and finds his own seam. Sometimes that's all it takes. Put a puck on net, crash it, clean up the loose change.
And then, ironically, it's Rasmus that ends up catching the first shot on that one. I think it was Fiala that had the first one that ends up stinging Rasmus. He can't quite get back into position. As you can tell, he was hurt, and inevitably it would lead to a backdoor one-timer that's finished off there by Anze Kopitar.
Yeah, good look at it there. It looked like it just caught him on the inside of the knee a little bit, so not a lot of padding, but, you know, and then it's tough. The cross-ice pass comes across. That's Anze Kopitar, and I mean, that's an elite sniper, and not much he can do in that situation. You know, you touched on the block shot. Man, both teams selling out tonight. It was pretty impressive.
It was, and actually had some physicality throughout the course of the night, too, and a little bit of edge. We saw a couple of conversations throughout the course of the night. The power play, though, special teams was the absolute difference, and this was power play goal, PP goal number three tonight, and Mackenzie Weegar, why not? He's done it at even strength. Second power play goal of the season.
Yeah, and a little extra juice on that celly, too. You love to see it from a guy like Mackenzie Weegar. And, you know, again, it goes back to what we talked about for the Rasmus Anderson created play on the Coleman goal. Again, you know, just move it back up to the top, get pucks on net, fire it through traffic, as we saw Weegar do. You know, it was interesting watching the team work on the power play. You don't get a ton of time in a morning skate to really fine-tune a lot of your game. It's really mostly about getting touches, but we saw some different plays developing here this morning. They spend a considerable amount of time on it, so they got the reward tonight, and again, it's about changing things up and keeping the killers on their toes.
So three power play goals, the difference in this hockey game. Mackenzie Weegar's got 18 on the season, and he's standing by now after his one goal tonight.
Yeah, just another goal. It was a great play. We talked about it. After the first couple power plays that, you know, one of their forwards sunk in, and I knew Hubie would find me with a no-look pass. I've seen that a couple of times. So it tipped off good old Trevi Cat, and luckily it went in.
Just a thought on the power play as a whole today, finding not only goals but at opportunistic times for you.
Yeah, it's big. It's something that we've obviously worked on all year long. It hasn't been easy for us, but I think in the last few games here, you know, we found some chemistry out there. You know, guys are starting to make plays, finding guys and shooting the puck a little bit more and giving us some momentum, so it's been good.
What lessons do you think the young players on this team can take away from a victory like this, not just for this season, but beyond?
I would say just the sacrifice for the body that it takes to win. You know, it wasn't an easy victory tonight. It was a battle. But I thought that, you know, a lot of guys, you know, mostly everybody, you know, sacrifice the body either to make a hit, block a shot, take a hit. And I think for the young guys, that's big, you know. You got to get dirty and sore sometimes to gut out some victories like this. So I'd say just, you know, the dedication it takes to get victories like that.
And your group has seen, you know, at times a lot of pucks, shots on net. Your goalie's been good for you. A game like this where they don't see as much, is it validating, I guess, for your group as a defensive group, how stingy you can be?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, our goal is not to let any goals in. Our goal is to break the puck out easy and then, you know, play offensively. And I thought for the most part that second period, I don't even think they had maybe one shot on goal. Towards the end, I think they got a couple with the power play. But just a great job, you know, blocking shots, you know, taking a hit to get the puck out, and you know that's what it takes to win in this league. It's sometimes it hurts.
When you're inching closer to 20 goals this season, and I'm sure you'd like to reach that milestone, but is that something you've legitimately thought about?
It's in the back of my mind a little bit for sure. It would be pretty cool, but I think you know, not for me, but you know, a lot of the teammates bring it up quite a bit, so it's something that I can't really get away from, but it would be cool. You know, the forwards have done such a great job finding me this year and letting me get my shot through with a great screen, or you know, whether it was a lucky tip like it was tonight. Things are just going my way like that this year.
On that second period penalty kill, when you're tapping Raz with your stick, is that like good job or please get up, or what's
yeah,
the message there?
Yeah, I'll say nicely to please get up for sure. But I know that feeling. It obviously hurts, and he's been great on the PK. He's one of those guys that have, you know, sacrificed his body for a big block shot. Obviously, it was kind of, you know, tough to let them score at the end there. It was just a broken play because he got hit. But yeah, definitely just a couple quick whacks on the butt to get the heck up.
One go down. Kill earlier when you blocked four or five.
Yeah, I'll let him know a little bit later. He's not too shy to let me know about things, so that's just great friendship.
What was the impact of Nazem Kadri kind of setting the tone in that first period?
Yeah, he was dominant in that first period. I think all year long, you know, he's been a force up the middle of the ice. Obviously getting that goal on the power play, setting somebody up on the other goal, and then the big hit I thought was pretty big for us as well, setting the tone physically, because I thought after that everybody got pretty engaged, and you know, on both sides of the ice, and you know, a lot of guys woke up, which we needed after coming off the road. Is that's what we need from a leader.
It's hard to miss when it happens in front of the home bench like that, isn't it?
Oh, that's the best. That's the best. That guy hears it for sure.
Thanks, Mikhail.
Oh, good. Thanks. Thank you.
Elite post-game interview there from Mackenzie Weegar to go along with his elite goal-scoring abilities this season. Love that from him. And he mentioned the block shots, and I know there was a number of them, alluding to the Rasmus Anderson one that took the leg out from underneath him momentarily. But Weegar finishes with 7 blocks tonight. And I think in the end, you know, statistically, it's not, you know, an insanely high block shot total. I think 18 for the club here tonight. But I think probably just speaks to more of the game in itself. And as he mentioned there, the physicality early on really did set the tone. You know, you look back to that Kadri hit, and there was a number of them in that first period. But this game did have some edge to it, didn't it?
It was interesting, yeah. We have a really unique position being down here, kind of nearish to the benches. So when Mackenzie says the guy hears about it, yeah, I think we can attest to that. Nazem Kadri, I mean, we talked about it with Martin Pospisil. Yeah. Weegs just touched on it as well. I mean, that's setting the tone, and whether it's waking guys up or at least getting them more engaged in the game. I mean, this is, even Pospisil said it, had that playoff type feel. That's kind of how you have to play in order to win at this level. And you know what? Where this team is in the standings is kind of irrelevant right now, because I go back to your first intermission interview when you talked to Nazem Kadri.
Yeah.
He just said, I want to win.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. So that's the kind of competitor the Flames have. And, you know, he's been such a leader for them all year. We saw it out there tonight.
Yeah, that's well said. I was thinking about that just as he was describing it, that, you know, Mackenzie talked about he's been dominant, or was dominant in the first, and he's been so good up the middle all season. I think that's the first thing that came to mind, is I asked him about that hit and trying to set the tone physically. And he just said, plain and simple, I just want to win. And, and I think that kind of showed tonight. He definitely was doing everything it takes to get that job done tonight. And they do. They get the victory. A big part of that being Rasmus Anderson had the helper on the power play shot that got through, and then eventually found the game-winning goal scorer in Blake Coleman. Here he is now as Rasmus Anderson.
It will be all right. Yeah, a little unfortunate. Just, you know, couldn't put any weight on it for a few minutes, but it will be all right.
What do you think of the event today?
It was pretty cool. It was cool. It was exciting, and, you know, the fans got involved too. So it was a cool event for sure, and really cool jerseys and really cool design.
What impressed you most in terms of what you saw from your group tonight?
Resiliency. You know, we played a 5-on-5. I don't think we really gave them anything. And, you know, a lot of shot blocks, you know, paying the price, scoring a few goals on the power play. So it was a lot to like about our game. And, you know, I don't know how many shots they have for 2 periods, but it wasn't many. So it was a lot to like from our team tonight.
What can young players learn from a victory like this tonight?
It's a hard league to win in, and you know, you got to pay the price night in, night out. And you know, NHL is a lot about, you know, knowing your role and thriving with your role. And if you have a shelter role, it's, you know, if you get an opportunity to take advantage of it. And that's what I think you know, our young players have done this year. You know, I think Pospy is, he's a pest out there.
Oh, sorry.
Night in and night out. And you know, it's him understanding his role. And I think Matty has been excellent since he got back. And I think Saris has been good all year. And so, you know, the opportunity is there. And you got to take it when you get it. And I think our young guys have done a really good job with that.
Rez, we always ask that sort of question. What can young guys learn from this? It wasn't very long ago that you were breaking into this league. Like, is tonight
6 years ago, Wes.
Yeah. I've been around longer than that. Is tonight a night that means something in the development of players?
Hard to say. I think the thing with, you know, young players, and myself included when I was young, is you don't realize how much or how many games it actually is. And, you know, there isn't a lot of practices, and especially this time of the year, it's everything is about the games, and or you travel, or, you know, playing in Canada on the west side, it's a lot of travel. And, you know, it's almost a slap in the face your first year, because you don't realize how you know, how much it takes on your body and mentally, you know, getting home at 2 a.m., have a day off the next day and then play, and then, you know, then you might leave again. And so it's, you learn a lot, and you learn how to deal with it. The longer your NHL career goes, and you know, it can be tough. You know, it's doesn't really matter what age you are, but you know, you learn how to deal with it. The older you get, and you more experience you have, because you know, the first few years are tough, and you know, then eventually when you get a family and a wife and kids and all that kind of stuff, it sucks to be without them, right? And you know, you're gone for large period of times during most of the year, and it's a learning curve. And but once again, I thought our young players have been excellent all year, and they've been really taking advantage of their opportunity, and they should be proud of themselves.
When you were a young player and you were going through what you're just describing, at what point did you feel that you were getting a handle of that adjustment?
You know, the one thing too, when it's your first year, everything is exciting, right? Mm-hmm. And so I think, you know, if you look around the league, a lot of young players, it's the second year that can be challenging for a lot of players. And because I think that's when, you know, you realize that, you know, you get paid a lot of money to do this, and it's not all sunshine and rainbows, even though it is. Don't get me wrong, it really is. You know, we all love our job, and we all love playing in the NHL, and we all love playing for the Flames. But you know, it's a mental grind, and it's a physical grind, a lot of nights, and it can be challenging. It really can be. And you know, you have ups and downs, and you know, with the social media world, you know, you read how terrible you are one game and how good you are the next, and so it's really, you got to learn how to cope with everything around it. And but once again, you know, the one I'm really impressed with is Maddie. You know, since he's been back up, I think he's playing with a lot of confidence and a lot of swagger, and you know, he's hanging on the pucks, he's making plays, and you know, he's going to be a really good player in this organization for a long time.
So what's your advice then to these young players that are coming up that are experiencing things that not too long ago you were experiencing?
Yeah, you know, honestly, not much the first year, right? It's, as I said, you know, the first year is exciting and new, and you're kind of, you know, you're just riding along kind of, and, you know, you see all the, you know, you see New York, you see Florida, like, you see the big cities, and you stay at nice hotels, you fly private and stuff like that. So I think the first year, you know, you're just enjoying it, and then, as I said, the second year can be challenging sometimes, and, but so far, you know, they've done a great job. All three, four, five, I don't know how many there's been, but they've done a good job, all of them. And, you know, just stay in the moment, stay present, and enjoy it. And, you know, if they come up to us next year or, you know, we see them struggling, or if they take the next step, you know, you're going to be by their side. And that's why, you know, you love playing on a team. You're in it together. And, you know, some nights you can be the hero and some nights you're the villain, and that's just the way it is. And so, you know, you always have your teammates back, and I think that's the one thing I love about our team too. It doesn't matter who you are, you know, we all try to get in the lane and blocking shots and standing up for each other, and you know, we all know what situation we're in. It's going to take a miracle to get in the playoffs, but we still show up on a night like tonight, and you know, we block shots, we hit, we play a physical game. We're all over a really good team for 60 minutes, and yeah, it's it was one of those nights when you look around and you know, you're proud of being this team.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Ryan.
Original 16, a great way to celebrate things done well.
All right, welcome back inside the Flames Postgame Live, brought to you by Original 16. And some great stuff there from Rasmus Anderson. He put not only tonight into context, but also a lot about just this team and the kind of the position they're in with a lot of young guys in the lineup, and you know what this night like tonight and maybe just a stretch like this can mean to them moving forward as well. And thought he summed it up really nicely, but also had some really kind words about the evolution he's seen from a lot of those young guys and the performance they put forward here on a consistent basis, tonight included. All right, let's get some thoughts from the head coach of the Calgary Flames. Here's Ryan Huskett now following tonight's 4-2 win over the Los Angeles Kings.
For the first time this season, you guys got three power play goals in a game. I mean, we've talked about the power play a lot. How does it feel to have three power play goals in the game and see it work so well tonight?
It was the difference in the game, right? So I thought they did a really good job. The one unit, two face-off goals face-off wins, which is a really big thing, and then the other unit shot the puck. So it's a good thing. So they should feel good about themselves tonight when they leave the rink.
How do you feel about your group's overall defensive effort? I mean, 15 shots against even strength, less than 20 overall. Overall, what worked for your team away from the puck?
Yeah, I loved it tonight. I thought we did a really good job. I think for us, it's more about the pressure up the ice, I think, that allowed us to have some success. Then I thought our guys were very detailed in the neutral zone. So they did a good job with our structure and made it hard for them to get through us. And then when they did in the third period a little bit, I thought Markey was excellent.
We just had a long chat with Rasmus Anderson about some of the young players and influencing them right now. What does it say when you see him block a shot? I know they score moments later, but then the Mackenzie Weegar shift on the kill, he eats a whole bunch of blocks as well. What's the impact that has on the young players?
Well, you'd like to think that they're going to pay attention to what they're seeing. I mean, that's the first thing. And I think there's standards. And whether you're in the playoffs, if you're out of the playoffs, you have to have standards and expectations of yourself first and foremost, and then of your teammates. That's the next thing. So if you're going to do things like that, then it's easy for you to expect someone else to do the same thing. And if you're looking to build something, those are things that are very important.
What's your reaction when that goal goes in after Rasmus blocks it and he just is too hobbled to kind of get there and close?
I was still steaming a little bit about the penalty. And we talk about young guys, there's a lesson that you learn against really good teams. So recognizing who you're on the ice with at certain times is an important thing. And then against good power plays, you don't want to give them opportunities, and they have a good power play. So. But having said that, I thought our overall game tonight was maybe one of our more complete ones of the year.
How important is Nazem Kadri, just the hits, the offensive aggression? How important was he tonight?
He was one of our best players, I thought. I mean, he brought people into the game. And when Naz is at his best, he drags people into the fight with him, whether it's a hit or if he's going in the net hard or he's making a good play. And he seemed to find a little chemistry with Kuzi as well lately. So Pospy's been Pospy. He just does his thing when he's on the ice. But I think when Naz is engaged, he's a driver, and he sucks people into the game with him.
We've spoken about how Nazem Kadri has helped young players on the ice, in particular Connor and Martin. How would you describe him as an influence on younger players in the locker room and off the ice?
I think what you see on the ice is what you see in the room as well. Naz is a vocal guy. When something's going the right way, he'll pat guys in the back. If things aren't going the way they should be going, he'll make sure people know it. And I think over probably his career, he's learned how to handle or tailor his message the right way to certain people. And that's part of being a little bit older or maturing or growing up, whatever you want to call it. So I think he's got a good handle on whether guys need a push or a kick or a hug.
Is there a certain value with a guy like Naz? Like, he's a guy, and you have other guys like this, but he's won in this league. You know, he's a guy who I'm sure is frustrated about where this team is in the standings. When he's setting the tone in a game that, you know, some people might look at and say, well, geez, it's sort of done for the season, does that have a different sort of value?
Yeah, I mean, and I would put Blake in that category too. So I don't think when you have guys that understand or winning is something that drives them, or they hate losing more than they like to win, it's infectious, as we talked earlier about that. And I think with Naz continuing to play the way he's played for the majority part of the year, I think it sends a real strong message to everybody. And he's played on Stanley Cup champion teams. Blake's played on them, so they have a real good handle on what it takes to win.
it's one thing for the players to try to motivate each other when they're in a stretch like this where the playoffs do look out of reach. How's it like for you to get your guys motivated from a coaching?
We are the same as we've been. Like, we have to, whether it's game one or game 72 or 73, we're pushing. We want to get them to a level where they expect the same things that we do. So, and part of it's bringing young guys along, as we've talked about a little bit, but it's part of it is demanding a lot from your older players as well. So that's kind of where our messaging's been over the last little while.
Given his pretty profound comments tonight, just Rasmus, a similar question, how have you seen him evolve as a leader in your time?
Well, I saw Raz when he was just a young fella. But I think it's, for him, it's a lot of growing up too. So for when I look at Raz, it's a little bit more of he wants to be a guy that's used in every situation. And early on, when you're a younger guy, everybody thinks I have to be out there for all offensive things. And why am I not out there in those situations? Well, it's as important now to him to be out at the end of a game like tonight. So I think that's where the growth in his game has come from. So he's maturing. Again, he's getting older.
What have been your impressions of Matthew Coronado these last few games?
I think Matthew's been pretty good. He's given us some good minutes. I feel like he's got a little bit of confidence again with the puck. He's made some good plays with it, yet he's still working. I feel like he's a little bit more re-energized than he was earlier when he was up with us, and maybe that's because he hasn't played quite as much, or we haven't practiced as much because of the way our schedule's been, but I feel like he's got some energy back.
Can I just get one more?
Sure.
We keep talking about young guys. I'm sure you heard that the Wranglers clinched a playoff spot tonight. You coach at that level. You got a bunch of guys up now. Can you just speak to the developmental importance of knowing those kids in your AHL team are going to get some playoff seasoning this year?
It's a really big thing. And it's hard to, when you look at the year that they've had, we've taken a lot of guys off their roster, a lot of guys. And for them to keep, you know, trudging along the way they have and finding ways to win, with us having taken a lot of their best players, as I mentioned, I think it's a credit to their entire staff, from Pask to Culler and all of his guys there. But to get the opportunity to play and hopefully play a long time in the playoffs is valuable for young guys. You don't get that experience anywhere else. And we've talked a lot about the American League, how important it is for young guys, and you don't have to feel like you have to rush them. It's okay for them to play there. It's even better if they get playoff experience.
Do events like the South Asia Night really bring the team together?
I think they're cool nights because everybody, how can I say this? Hockey is something that has really become about everybody and inclusion and bringing different people into the mix. And the South Asian Night tonight, you know, everybody has friends that are, you know, from all the different areas, I guess I can say. So I think they're neat nights for the guys. They enjoy it. And you get a chance to learn a little bit about different cultures as well. You know, I know they look up and they see the different outfits that people are walking down the stairs with at times. All that stuff is neat for the players to see. And being a part of these events are really neat for them for sure. Okay, thank you.
All right, some good stuff there. Once again, a little bit more broadly and a little bit more specific to tonight's 4-2 win, kind of all parts there as the Calgary Flames play this final stretch of hockey games. It was 10 entering tonight, so just 9 games left in the regular season. Obviously, the playoff hopes are, as it was put, I think, a couple of times, it's looking like it would be quite a miracle pass in order to get in there, but still playing hard and still playing for what's on the line, and obviously not eliminated just yet. Also put a little ding into the Calgary put a little ding into the LA chances right now as well. I mean, obviously they're in a pretty good spot, but at this time of year, those are all magnified, each and every point that isn't gained.
Yeah, you want to be finding your game at this time of year too, and we're seeing some teams in that race really elevate their game, and others like LA who had a 4-game winning streak snap the other night, and now all of a sudden you're staring down the barrel of a 2-game losing streak, so you want to fix that as quickly as you can. So fascinating time of year, because it always feels like by the time the Flames take to the ice the next time will be April. It feels like we're right, you know, closing stretch of the season, but we still do have 9 games and 3 weeks, of hockey left, so there's lots of time for those teams to figure things out, and for the Calgary Flames, obviously, to build off what we saw tonight, because there was a lot of good.
Sure was, and for the Calgary Flames, the power play will stand out. They get 3 on the man advantage. First time this season they've done that, and obviously get the victory. That snaps the losing skid onward and upward for the Calgary Flames, who now are staring at a Tuesday night game against the Anaheim Ducks. That's their next matchup, and the next one on home ice as well. After that, it'll be a quick trip to Winnipeg upcoming for the Calgary Flames as they play out this final stretch and into April. March is now in the rearview mirror, at least in terms of games. And you can enjoy your Easter Sunday. We'll see you right back here at the Scotiabank Saddle Dome on Tuesday night. Thanks for watching Flames Post Game Live, brought to you by Original 16. Enjoy a great taste and remember to celebrate things done well with Original 16, official beer of the Calgary Flames.